Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just plead for you. Lord, we just plead the blood of Jesus. Oh, we just plead the blood of Jesus. Lord, look at the war that's been going on. Lord, sometimes people don't know what goes on in our minds, Lord God. Somebody don't know the war that comes against us, Lord God. Somebody don't know some of the things we receive in our young years, Lord God, that don't belong to us. I want to explain something to you. I want you to understand this. And it's nothing personal, but I want you to understand this. When you are born into the world, there is a demon assigned to you. We're born in sin, reared in iniquity. Now that demon will cause you to offend somebody or put somebody in your pathway to hurt you, to harden your heart to the point where you can't forgive. And when you can't forgive, you can't go any higher. You cannot be blessed. Now, it was not that person, but sin working through that person. And the way you find this out is when you examine your own life and you realize some of the things that you've been through and some of the things you said and done that really was not you, and you know it was not you. I think Apostle Paul said it like this: it's not I, but sin that lives in me. He said, when I would do right, I find myself doing wrong, and I found out it was not me, it was sin. And God told us to forgive sin, to forgive people of their sin, so that he could take that sin up out of the world. He wanted to take it up out of the world. You have to release it to God. If you hold it on to sin, if you hold it on to unforgiveness, if you hold it on to it, God won't take it from you. You have to give it to God. He placed before you an open door. So when you say, Lord, I forgive everybody of everything that has ever happened to me, Lord God, you release, you plant a seed that God can give you the harvest of you being forgiven. So right now, in the name of Jesus, right now, Lord God, say this with me. Say, Lord, I don't even have to remember any incident of what it was, but I do forgive. There is nothing, Lord, that I do not forgive and put in your hand. Lord, I thank you. The sin in the Garden of Eden was just not obeying you. When I forgive, I obey you. And when I obey you, you cover me. And when you cover me, there's no weapon formed against me that shall prosper. Every tongue to rise up against me in judgment, I shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and the righteousness is of me, the Lord. And because I have obeyed God, I have obeyed my master. I am his servant, and these blessings are now mine. Ooh, look at there. Ooh, look at there, God. You done had some weight that's been holding you down. You should have been soaring. You should have been flying. You done connected with some people that's been holding you down. You should have been soaring. You should have been a lot higher than where you are now. But God is wiping away every slate. You have forgiven all, and you have been forgiven. Now, God don't want you to go through a guilt trip and hold on nothing or nobody, because you've already forgiven and you've been forgiven. It's time to go off into new things. It's time for a new beginning. All things have just become brand new in Jesus' name.
Amen. Uh-huh. Amen.
Amen.
All
things. Thank
you. All things have just become brand new. That's what God said when he said forgive. Mm-hmm. God is saying, just obey me. Just believe me. Just trust me. And I'll open your eyes up to what's really been going on. And I'll show you what's really been stopping you. And I'll show you why it's been stopping you. It's not because of them, or them. It's because of the blessing I blessed you with before you got here. Yeah. You were predestined to be great. Somebody go ahead and say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.